session, we will discuss about the international capital budget. Normally, I see the capital budgeting. So there are so many methods through which we are going to calculate whether the project to be accepted or the project to be rejected. In this session, we will discuss how it has to apply for international related problems. Okay. The first problem has been displayed on the screen. Just check the first column. Just I'll highlight the very big problem is there. Just I'll give the key highlights. In this problem, what they given is the initial investment is French franc 60 million or equal dollar 12 million. The current spot rate is dollar 0.20. Investment on plant and investment on plant and equipment is French franc 10 billion is needed for working capital, and the interest rate on loan is 10%. The loan principal is to be paid in 10 years. They get year price, demand, and variable cost. Year 1 to 3, they get price, they get demand, and they are in the variable cost. The fixed cost are estimated to be French franc 5 million per year. Fixed cost, French franc 5 million per year. Then again, they have given some other information like plant and equipment are depreciated over 10 years. That comes to French franc 6 million per year. If you take plant and machinery depreciation, and even they have required rate of interest 15%. With this information, we will try to calculate this particular problem. Okay, so let's come back and let's see what they are given. Okay, so they are given price, demand, and variable cost. How much price they are given? 600, and demand is 40,000 units. 40,000 units is demand, and 600 is the price. If you multiply these two things, I am writing French franc in million. To simplify, I am writing everything denomination French franc and we are writing in million. Okay. We are writing in a denomination is in million. The CSS we have taken, CSS 600 into 40,000. It comes to 24 lakh divided by 10 lakhs, we get a 24. CS we get a 24. So if multiply these two, 600 into 40,000 divided by 10 lakhs, so you get a 24, then followed by 32, 24, 32, and 42. So first year, second year, and third year, 642. Variable cost, as we know, variable cost is 25 into 40,000. So it comes to variable cost is 1.50, and lastly 2.40, and then CS means variable cost, we get a contribution. So the contribution get a, if you take, if you deduct this from this, you get a contribution is 23 and 31. Then 39.60. Okay. Then, as we know, the fixed cost they have in column as 5 million. Fixed cost is 5 million. Fixed cost is 5 million. So, contribution as fixed cost, we get EBIT 18. EBIT 18 comes to 18. Then 26 and 34, then 34.60 here, sorry, 34.60. Then depreciation, as you know, it is 60 million divided by 10 years. The plant, the useful life of the plant is for 10 years. 60 million divided by 10, we get 6 million as a depreciation. Similar depreciation, and then EBIT, if you calculate EBIT, so the EBIT comes to 18 minus 6 is 12, 26 minus 6 is 20, and 34.60 minus 34.60 minus 6. Okay, we'll get 28.60. Okay, so this is EBIT. Then interest. If you take the interest, interest amount comes to 1, as it is 10% on 10 lakh, it comes to 1, 10 million, 10% on 10 million. EBT, earnings before taxes, 11, then 19, then 27.0. Okay, so then we got earnings before tax. Then we have no tax, as I mentioned, there is no tax assets. Earnings of tax has been seen. Okay, so add depreciation. If you want to calculate, if you want to get CFAT, CFAT is EAT plus depreciation. So depreciation, as you know, it is already, you know, it is 6. Depreciation is 6. If you add depreciation, you get CFAT 17. Then 25. 25. Then lastly, thirty three point six zero. So we know the salvage value. Salvage value will come in only terminal. So at the end of the project, how much value we are going to get back? It is, you mentioned as a 42 million. Salvage value is 42 million. Okay. So moving ahead here, total cash flow. Total cash flow is, so CFAT, we got CFAT plus net salvage value. Okay. That is 70. Then followed by 25. Then lastly, 75.60. So 75.60 means 33.60 plus 42.42 will get 75.60. Withholding tax, they mentioned withholding tax as 10%. They give problem. Withholding tax as 10%. So 10% on these values. Okay. So 10% 17 is 1.70, 2.5, 7.56. These are the answers what you get withholding tax. Then net remittance, this minus this net remittance is 15.30, 15.30, 22.50, 22.50, and lastly 68.02. 68.04. The present value 15%. If they are given table values, you have to use the table values. If they get ready answer, you can use the ready answer. Other way also, you can use the table value. If you see first year 15%, the answer what you get is 0.87. The present value is 0.87, then 0.76, and lastly 0.66. This in the exam, this may be given in the problem, or the mass you to check it by using the table values. Okay, the present value, if I multiply these two, we get a present value 13.30, 17.01, 17.01, and then 44.74. Okay, forward exchange rate, as you know, as we already discussed here. Forward exchange for the 1 year. We have mentioned here forward exchange for 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. They mentioned it as a, you can see here for 1 year it is 0.22, and for second year it is 0.25, and for third year 0.28. So that is, so how to write this one is, for $1, for one French franc, one French fry 0.22 dollar. Okay, so now it is a French fry we are converting to dollar. So 13.30 French fry is equal to how much? So 13.30 into 0.22. Same thing. 13.30 into 0.22. We get the answer as 2.93. This is in dollars. You should note. This is in dollars. 2.93, 4.25, 4.25, and 12.53. Okay. So this is basically presently in terms of dollar. So rest part you are aware of that. How to calculate the NPV? NPV is equal to present value of cash inflow minus present value of cash outflow. Okay. Present value of cash inflow is 2.93 plus 4.25 plus 12.53. So we get a 19.71. That is 2.93, 4.25, 12.53. Add all these things. 2.93, 4.25, 12.53. Add all these things. We get a 19.71. So minus present value of cash outflow is 12. Already given. So you can see here. So total outflow is 1 French franc is equal to spot rate is 0.20 dollar. So we have 60 French franc is how much? If you calculate 60 into 0.2, you get a $12. Okay. So this way also we can do, or directly the problem itself they are given. The cash outflow is $12. Okay. So the net present value is you get a 7.71. So as it's first due, we can say this project can be accepted. Okay. This is question number A. In question number B, what they are given? If the company, assume that the parent company provides the additional funds for working capital so that the loan from France government is not necessary. So if we take a loan from the France government, we have to make an additional payment. Suppose assume that if the company, its parent company itself provides the another amount, further amount for the working capital, then how the problem looks like. Okay. So this one, just if you make a small twist in the correct answer for this, you can see here. So here we have, once we have the salvage value, after salvage value, we have one more thing called salvage value of working capital. This is question B I'm saying. Okay. If they include salary value, if the French franc company, if they provide working capital instead of borrowing money from the French government, then so what we do? Salary value of working capital that comes to 10 million. Okay. So then instead of 75.60, here the amounts get changed. Instead of 75.60, we get a 85.60, then 8.56 is the withholding tax, the net remittance comes to 77.04. Okay, present value is 0.66. Okay, if you take this 0.66 as a present value, then if multiply, we get a 44.74, and as we know that third year forward exchange is 0.28. If you multiply these two things, we'll get a 14.18. Okay. So it is for problem B. So present value cash inflow comes to 21.36 minus 12. The net answer what you get is 7.2. So that completes the this particular first column on international capital budgeting. So thank you for watching the video. So next video I'll be going into one more column where we'll be discussing the similar lines we'll be discussing, and third column will be going with the most important, that is when same column how to do the two different approach, that is home currency approach as well as the foreign currency approach. Thank you.